In this video, we're going to be talking about the real number system. So to begin, we're going to go ahead and first look at this foldable here. So for this foldable, we want to go ahead and categorize the real number system. So to begin, if you would go off to the top right corner and label this as the real number system. So within the real number system, we have two categories. We have rational numbers and we also have irrational numbers. I first want to talk about rational numbers, and we're going to go ahead and look at the innermost subset of rational numbers. So this innermost subset is known as your natural numbers. Now, when I talk about natural numbers, you might also know this as counting numbers. So when you typically start counting, you start off by counting at 1, then you go to 2, 3, so on and so forth. Now, in your next set, this is called, or these are called, your whole numbers. Now, the difference between whole numbers and natural numbers is that they now include the number 0. So here we have 0, 1, 2, 3, so on and so forth. Then in our next set, we have integers. So the difference between whole numbers and integers is that integers now include negative numbers. So for instance, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, but they're also going to include your whole numbers, which are 0, and your natural numbers. So, and they will go on forever and ever in both directions, as long as they are, as long as they don't include decimals. So they can be negative, they can be 0, and they can be positive numbers. Then in our outermost set, these are known as your rational numbers. Now, rational numbers are any number that can be written as a fraction. So, or they can have a terminating or repeating decimal. So, an example of a rational number could be 1/3. You can have negative 2 1/3 or negative 2 1/2. You can have 0.11 repeating. We can have 0.5, negative 0.7. And then you also have to remember that rational numbers are going to include, they're going to include integers. So you can have negative 1. You can have a whole number. You can have 0. You can have a natural number and you can have 4. These are all examples of rational numbers. These are all categorized as rational numbers. So then on the other, in the other category, we have irrational numbers. So an example of an irrational number could be, for instance, the square root of 2. If you were to put the square root of 2 in your calculator, for instance, you would see that you would get, for instance, 1.4121. Here we don't see a pattern within the number. It's not a repeating decimal. It's not a terminating decimal. So this would be an example of an irrational number. Another example of an irrational number that you might be familiar with is pi. Now, pi goes on forever and ever. It does not end. It does not terminate. It does not have a repeating decimal. So here, these two would be good examples of irrational numbers. So that is the real number, that is the real number system categorized. So now that we know this, we want to go ahead and now look at the purple foldable, which is going to be this foldable here up at the top. So we're going to go ahead and look at the real numbers foldable now. And we're going to start off by looking at number 1. So for number 1, we want to know which letter is closest to the square root of 47. So we want to first find out what is the square root of 47 equal. So we're going to go ahead and open up our calculator, and we want to get the square root symbol. So to get the square root symbol in your calculator, you're going to want to go to Control, and then you're going to want to hit X squared. Again, Control X squared, and the X squared is next to the number 4. And then we're going to type in 47, so the square root of 47. And the square root of 47 is going to be 6.8, 5, I'm going to round 6.855, I'm going to round that to 6.86. So the square root of 47 is 6.86. So now we want to determine where the square root of 47 best lies. So since it equals 6.86, I know that it should be in between 6 and 7. So I'm really only looking in between this area. Now, the only point that I see that is closest to the square root of 47 is going to be E. So here, E is my answer. E is the closest to the square root of 47. Now let's go ahead and take a look at number 2. So for number 2, it says, on which number line does point P best represent the approximate value of the square root of 33? So again, we're going to go to our calculator and we want to type control x squared. Control x squared is going to pop open the radical sign or the square root symbol. So now we're going to type in 33. So the square root of 33 equals 5.74. So the square root of 33 equals 5.74. So here I know 5.74 is greater than 5 and it's less than 6. So it's in between 5 and 6. So I'm actually going to go ahead and look at my answer choices. If you look at your number line here, since there are 1, 2, 3, 4 marks in between your numbers, these are going by point twos. So this is point 2, point 4, point 6, and point 8. So since my number has to be at 5.74, I'm going to go ahead and put this point on each number line. So 5.74, this is 5.2, 5.4, 5.6, 5.74 is going to be at about right here. It looks like F is going to be a good option for the square root of 33. Let's go ahead and take a look at the rest of them. So for G, if I go to 5.74, I do not see that point P is listed anywhere near G. So I can go ahead and cross that out. If I look at H, if I plot 5.74 on the number line, again, where they have point P plotted is not close to 5.74, so I can cross H out as well. And if I go down to J, if I plot 5.74 on the number line, again, point P is nowhere near J. So J, I can cross that out as well. So here, the letter that best represents point P is going to be F. Okay, so that was numbers 1 and 2. Now let's go ahead and take a look at number 3. So for number 3, it says Johnny drew the Venn diagram below to classify 10 different numbers. The shaded part of the diagram best represents what? So first, I want to go ahead and identify what these subsets are within the real number system. So here I can tell that this innermost set in my Venn diagram, these are integers. I see negative numbers, I see zero, and I see positive numbers. So these are integers. And then in the outermost set, I see fractions and decimals. So here, this lets me know that this set, these are rational numbers. So now I want to look and see which statement best represents this relationship. So A says integers as a subset of rational numbers. So this word subset means inside of. So here this is saying I have integers inside of rational numbers. So here that is a good statement for this Venn diagram. For B, I have whole numbers as a subset of rational numbers. So if we are saying whole numbers is this subset, this is saying whole numbers are inside of rational numbers. The shaded region is not whole numbers. Negative numbers are not whole numbers. So you can cross B out. C says rational numbers as a subset of integers. Rational numbers are not inside of integers. Rational numbers are on the outside of the integer set. So we can cross C out. And then D says irrational numbers as a subset of real numbers. These are not irrational numbers. They are either whole numbers, they're negative numbers, they are fractions or terminating decimals. So that would not be a good statement. And here the best statement is going to be A, again, that integers are a subset or inside of rational numbers. Okay. Lastly, we're going to go ahead and look at number four. So for number four, it says, which diagram best represents the relationship among rational numbers, irrational numbers, and real numbers? So referencing your chart at the bottom, when we talked about the real number system, again, we know that it is called the real number system. So based off of that alone, when we look at these diagrams, we can automatically cross B out because it is not called the rational number system. Then we know that the real number system is split into two separate categories and they do not overlap. We know we have rational numbers on one side and we have irrational numbers on the other. So the only diagram that would best represent the relationship among rational, irrational, and real numbers is D. So that concludes real numbers.